in Palm Bay, Florida, heading down Babcock Road towards the famous StickMarsh Farm 13 bass fishery. And today's a little bit different than the last time I went down here to catch bass in 1992. Today we're going down to use some Geotube technology to restore some vegetation in the StickMarsh that was wiped out during the 2004 hurricane. So come along for the journey. A little orientation of where the water comes from. Down here is State Road 60, okay, and the water comes out of the Fort Drum Marsh Conservation Area through what we call the Anson Garcia East and West. The district calls it the Blue Cypress Water Management Area. Then the water comes out of Anson Garcia down the L76 into the StickMarsh Farm 13 area. And that's where the work's going to be. It's going to be up here in the StickMarsh, okay? And the water flows out of the StickMarsh into Three Forks Reservoir and out to the Upper St. John. So today our work's going to be on the east side of the StickMarsh, where we're trying to put this geotube at, and we're planting the bulrush and the geotube in areas that would normally be too deep to plant vegetation. I'm here with Skip with Gator Dredging, and Skip is the expert with the geotube. I've only seen him filled up, so Skip's going to tell you a little bit about how this actually works.
This operation that you see set up here is designed to take sand from the shore, liquefy it with water, and pump it out into the bags to fill the bags themselves. We're using 100-foot long bags and 200-foot long bags, and basically we start right up here on the shore with sand delivered by dump trucks. We load it into this sluiceway that has got continuous water flowing through it. And then, as you can see at the end of the sluiceway, all that sand and water mixture falls into a small basin with a 6-inch pump that then begins to suck it out of the basin and send it out to the tubes. And basically, we're looking to fill a 200-foot tube in about 4 hours. We're filling two simultaneously off the same pump.
We can figure out on how to plant vegetation in deep water. This is going to revolutionize aquatic plant revegetation projects. It's not just going to be done here at the StickMarsh. People are going to want to do this all over the state of Florida, probably all over the Southeast. This is the final stage, this is the planting stage. The tubes have been filled up with the sand, okay, allowing for a false substrate that allows the bulrush to be planted in water that normally would never survive if it's too deep. So now it's maybe a foot and a half above the tube, and they're actually taking a shovel of sorts, putting it into the geotube, creating a hole, pushing it forward, sliding the bulrush into that hole, pulling the shovel out, and then zip tying the hole. And what I've heard, you know, if we allow this to go for a month and it establishes, then it'll be good to go. This first month's going to be very critical as far as pop-ups come. So we'll see. But it's kind of neat to see the new technology used here on the StickMarsh. It's been used at Disney and Bay Lake, but never here or anywhere else really on public waters in Florida. So if this works, more than likely we'll have quite a bit of requests. Matter of fact, I just got a request from somebody in the lower St. John's River wanting to use this technology down there. So all eyes are on this project right now.